Now we're getting into a whole other kind of nonfiction writing, and it's called explanatory writing. It also has two other names, which are?
Procedure.
How many of you in elementary school, maybe going way back even, wrote in how-to paper, like how to tie your shoes, how to feed your cat, something like that? Okay, very good. So we're kind of familiar. In sixth grade, it looks a little bit different, right? We've seen a rubric from yesterday and today. We know that we're going to be doing a little bit more, and we're going to talk about the focus for today. Before we get started,
even though her sixth
chart.
Graders
so
are familiar with the
down.
Format, Ms. Ramsey takes time to review some of the key elements of explanatory writing.
So what are some of the things that we know about it? What do we know, Edwin?
Procedural writing is something that you write about that somebody else doesn't know, and you have to give some information to tell them how to do it.
Yes, that's exactly right. We are writing instructions for somebody who does not know how to do it. What do we call that, somebody who does not know how to do it? A what?
A novice.
A novice or a beginner, right? So we are, the audience for our writing is, we're writing for?
Novices.
Novices and beginners, right? I love that word. What else do we know? Kayvon?
Procedural or how-to means, like, or explanatory means to explain in steps.
Exactly. So we know procedural writing has a very specific format, doesn't it, right? Like, you can't just start going off writing it in paragraph form like we've been doing. We're kind of going to break that a little bit today. Actually, it's going to be easier because we have these different chunks and we know exactly what information goes inside. What besides the steps are part of the structure, Taijung? Can you give me an example?
Introduction.
Good. So we have an intro. What's another one? Yell it out.
Materials and background.
Safety. And what's the last one?
Conclusion.
Very good. There we go. There are my answers. All right. Do we know anything else about procedural writing? Who writes it? People who are what?
Experts,
right?
And you need transition words.
Jeffrey, can you repeat that for me?
I said they're experts when they write it, but then when they reread it, they're trying to be like novices.
Right. And why is that, Rashard?
So then we can go back and change like our mistakes.
And include stuff that we know is not clear or where it needs more information, right? So thinking back to your old how-to from first grade, it was probably very basic, right? First you do this, then you do this. We're gonna do some more explaining, okay, Kayvon?
When you use transition words, don't keep repeating it. Like, we don't try to use and as much.
Okay, that's a great tip. But I also like how you brought up that we're going to even use transitional words, right? What else do we use in our procedural writing? What other kind of words? What other kind of vocabulary?
Talking about DSV?
Yes, I am talking about
the
DSV.
The main specific vocabulary.
And what does that mean, Charles?
It means like the main words that you will use.
So, you know, my example was how to plant a sunflower, and Laquan is writing about how to fold an origami crane. I doubt he's going to be talking about potting soil and seedlings. Those are my domain-specific words. I doubt that I'll be writing about transverse folds and diagonal crush folds and all those other fancy terms that he'll probably use today, okay? Well, Ms. Ramsey stayed up till like midnight last night writing her own piece. I thought if you guys are gonna write a procedural writing piece, it's only fair that I do as well. So today you'll get to see a finished piece, and then we're gonna identify some things that I've included that come from our rubric, and these are the types of things that I want you to steal for your own writing as well, okay? So here we go. My procedural writing topic is how to plant a sunflower. So I'm going to read the introduction to you. And this is just my introduction. I've included my own voice. And so if you hear me putting my own voice in, will you all clap for me today?
Yeah.
Okay, so here we go.
Modeling is an important strategy for any grade level or subject area. Ms. Ramsey can use her own work as a practical example to the students. For instance, after the introduction, she can review what happened when she worked on the materials list.
All right, so now I want to show you my materials list. When I sat down and I thought, yeah, what do I need to plant a sunflower? I thought like four or five things. Yeah, no. You need 10 things. And that's because when we're giving instructions as experts to novices, right, for our audience, we want to make sure that we're being very thorough. So mammoth sunflower seeds, one small bag of potting soil, one small to medium pot. What if I just said one pot, one bag of soil? Would that have been helpful to the person following instructions?
No.
No, they might have got like a 300-pound bag of soil if it existed, I don't know. So you're going to over-explain, even though at times it may seem a little bit silly, okay? Here's step one, and I'm gonna read this one to you as well. This time, what we're looking for, adverbs. And what's an adverb again?
It describes a verb.
It describes a verb, it describes an action word. These adverbs are so important when you're writing procedural writing because it tells you how to do something, right?
Yes.
If you crack an egg gently, it's different than just saying crack the egg. Because when I hear the word crack, I'm thinking, you know? So remember, we're writing to novices. So when you hear an adverb, I want you to clap. And if you happen to hear any domain-specific words, you can also, let's raise our hand. So I'm just gonna read the first step to you. First, you will need to gather all of your materials and put on your gardening gloves. Open your bag of potting soil and slowly fill it up, about 3/4 or by leaving 5 to 6 inches at the top. This extra space will allow your seedling, domain-specific word, your seedling to grow, and you can add more soil, right? These are not adverbs, these are words that would only be in mine. What are you writing about, Jaquan?
How to make a BLT sandwich.
So you're not gonna be writing about soil in your BLT, or at least I hope not, really I do.